So, are you a narcissist or do you have narcissistic tendencies based on your personality? So, today we will study the two types of narcissism. First, there is grandiose narcissism, and then there is vulnerable narcissism. And we will see that based on the traits of the Big Five, one can know if one tends to be either a grandiose narcissist or a vulnerable narcissist. So, what is the common core of narcissism? It is being disagreeable and especially being low in politeness, that is, being aggressive, exploitative, competitive, and having low humility. And now we will see in the detail the three domains which influence narcissism, which are neuroticism, extraversion, and of course, agreeableness. So let's start with the most well-known type of narcissism, which is grandiose narcissism. So, grandiose narcissism is first and foremost explained not by agreeableness but by extroversion. So, people high in extroversion will tend to be more concerned by grandiose narcissism. And not only in extroversion, but especially in assertiveness. Because both aspects, assertiveness and enthusiasm, affect the type of disorder called grandiose narcissism. So, extroversion and in extroversion, especially assertiveness, with a very high correlation. Second comes neuroticism. And it is reversed. So it is emotional stability. So a grandiose narcissist will have more emotional stability. And especially if you go to the level of the aspects, low withdrawal, that is, low level of depression, low level of anxiety, low level of self-consciousness. So, the low level of neuroticism of the grandiose narcissist is explained first and foremost by low withdrawal, that is, low anxiety and low depression. And finally comes agreeableness, and agreeableness is negatively correlated with grandiose narcissism, and it is especially the aspect of low politeness, which accounts for it, that is the fact of being exploitative, of being competitive, of not cooperating with others. Now we go to vulnerable narcissism. So, vulnerable narcissism is explained first and foremost by high neuroticism, so it is the contrary of grandiose neuroticism. And the correlation is pretty high, but both the aspects weigh the same, that is, withdrawal and volatility are both factors of neuroticism weighing on vulnerable narcissism. Then comes extroversion, and this time it is the reverse of grandiose narcissism. People high in vulnerable narcissism have low extroversion and are low in both aspects of assertiveness and enthusiasm, that is, positive emotions and sociability. And then there is a slight negative correlation with agreeableness for both aspects of politeness and even of compassion, that is, of caring for others. So, to sum up, narcissists are people who tend to be aggressive with others, who tend to compete with others, who tend to be exploitative of others, And in the case of vulnerable narcissism, they especially don't really care about others. So this is the common core. And when you come to neuroticism and extroversion, grandiose and vulnerable are opposite, because grandiose is high in vulnerable is high in neuroticism, whereas grandiose is low, and vulnerable is low in extroversion, whereas grandiose is high, and especially high in assertiveness. So to sum up, a grandiose narcissist is somebody who is not very polite, who is very assertive, and who has much emotional stability in terms of depression and withdrawal and anxiety. A vulnerable narcissist is somebody who is very high in neuroticism in general, very low in extroversion in general, and who tends to be low in agreeableness in general. So please leave a comment and I will try to answer very quickly. Thank you.